Mr. Martin, where are you? Thank you for hosting us this afternoon. We are happy to be at Camden Station and looking forward to our student showcase.
Yeah, our pleasure. Welcome. I'm going to try to go as quick as I can because there's three different things that we want to highlight that all fall under the umbrella of technology and creativity and innovation and things like that. So I'm going to be as brief as I can so that and we're going to finish with the Lego robotics here, which is going to take the majority of the time. But, you know, at Camden, like all the other schools here in Oldham County, you know, we believe that technology integration is very important to 21st century learning. But it can't be integration where we just throw things out because they look fun, they look cute. You know, we want to make sure that we're very intentional with how and when we integrate that technology and at what level. So to begin with our iPads, when those first came out, we started with those this is our fifth year. And we are up to right now about 175 devices in our school. Each staff member that has one, we have certified and classified staff members that have an iPad, they each present kind of a mini grant on how the research that they have done on implementation of it in the classroom and how they think it's going to increase student achievement. And once they submit that and we take a look at it and approve that, then they get one. So currently, all but one staff member have an iPad at Camden Station. We have 128 student iPads, and we currently in the hopper have 55 more requests. So when and we get funding throughout the year, we'll continue to add on more iPads. And we have a cart back there that you can look at after the meeting if you'd like. That each time we get about 25 or 30 of those, we have a cart that syncs those. But I have some students that came tonight that, because we have three one-to-one classrooms. We have a kindergarten and a third grade and a fifth grade classroom that are all one-to-one. So we had some students from each of those classrooms that wanted to join us tonight. And if they'll come up, Lily Beal and London Bayless, Logan Potts, and Gabriel Cripps. These are our kindergarten students. Every one of these has their own iPad in the classroom. Third grade, we have Sophie Nadinger, Alana Williams, and A.B. Bayless. These are our third grade students. They're in Ms. Schott's third grade class. Our kindergarten students are in Ms. Murphy's kindergarten class. And fifth grade, Ms. Pfeiffer's class, we have a few here, Andrew Park, Jesse Taylor, and Baxter Dirks. They'll come on over. And so they, like I said, we have a one-to-one. They use those every day. So if you have any questions for students, now's your perfect time.
Wow.
I didn't quite warn them. But.
Board members? Anybody want to jump in here? I'd like to know from a kindergartner, what do you do with your iPad in school? Let's start with Mr. Y Soccer Man. Logan?
We play on iPads.
Oh.
We do too.
Okay. Do you use your iPad to learn things in school too?
Yes.
Yes. Can you give me an example? Maybe somebody wants to jump in here, Mr. Martin.
I excel.
Lily, tell me what
IXL
is. What is it?
Do math.
Oh, excellent, Lily. And I bet you're a great math student. A lot of us freeze up when
books.
We have this microphone.
And read books.
You read books.
Such as? Do you know the name?
Yeah. Magic Treehouse.
Oh, Magic Treehouse.
Okay.
Excellent. How about it? Let's hear from a third grader. Oh, one more kindergartner. Thinking. Let's come back to you, okay? Third graders?
Mm-hmm. So, we do reflect student on our iPads. Reflex Student is like this app you can get, and if you have an account, you can use it to become more fluent in your math facts.
Ah, it's called Reflex Student.
Well, that's the name of the app. I think the name of the actual website is Reflex Math.
Okay, excellent. Good example.
Sure. Actually, sure. Sometimes our teacher does demonstrations on the iPad, like a whiteboard, and we usually use that as videos sometimes to watch them to understand some of our math skills.
So you can see the same thing on your iPad that she's doing on the whiteboard?
Mm-hmm.
Great example. Fifth graders.
There's an app we use called Notability, which is like our teacher can mail us a text, and we can highlight it and determine the importance.
Ah, good example. Anybody else?
I do. We search writing because we have to thing so we could have, because we're doing paragraphs for and so we have to get a correct information for it, so we have to so it won't be wrong.
Such as factors, we also use internet websites such as Google Junior. We sometimes put those facts into presentations. There's this app, there's apps where we create presentations for our peers and parents to look at and learn.
So nice summary. We see a progression from our kindergartners through third and fifth grade as to how technology is being used in your classrooms. Great examples, Mr. Martin.
Yeah, we really invite you all to come in, especially see that kindergarten classroom with the iPads. It is very impressive what Ms. Murphy is doing. It's differentiating for each student and how she can do that by using iPads, which makes it a lot more efficient.
Yes.
So
that by the time you are our ages, well, iPads will be old-fashioned, first of all. But no telling what kind of technology you all will be using. Great job. Thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks, Camden Eagles.
I want to talk real quick, too, about our 3D printer, which is back there printing something right now. This is, even though we just recently got that, it's been 2 years in the making. And we have some students who are in the 3D printer club. A few of them are here. I'm going to say their names. The ones that are here can come on up. But Sawyer Taylor, Caitlin McGee, Yasmin Zamora, Cameron Sove is here. Landon Wally, Jesse Taylor is here. Nicholas Hom, JT Lowe, Lexi Ryan, and Baxter Dirks is here. So you guys come on up. Like I said, it's been 2 years. We've been researching on this, collaborating with a lot of people, knowing that there's something out there that would be different than what we have been providing for our students. We want to thank several people who have helped us with that. Mr. Farm at Oldham County Middle School and Denise Cayley from East. Mr. Watkins has been a huge help for us as they have started that at the Arvin Center along with Terry Tunnell there. Mark Harrell from Project Lead the Way, we've been working with him also. We even got involved with some DTCs, Lee Collard at Anchorage and Larry Jesse from, he's the DTC at Eminence. You know, we have collaborated with all of those people to make sure we had a good idea and made some smart decisions before purchasing something that costs that much and to make sure it doesn't collect dust. And so we just started our 3D printing club just last Friday. It was the first time we met. The first time the kids got a chance to see it in action. And already Monday morning, they have been on Tinkercad over the weekend and have come with things they want us to print out already. But, you know, if you take a look at the things back there, especially the ones on the front row there, this is a learning process, and our students know they're going to work a little bit individually, but a lot together. One of the things that we made here to begin with was an egg that when you look around, it looked like it was going to turn out something pretty cool. being printed out separate parts. So we worked with the design a little bit and came up with this, which was a failure. Flip that around and try to build it from the top down, and got better. So each one got a little bit better. This one still is a failure. Students, and this is one that we were going to print tonight for you guys, and you see what it made. So it was a lot of trial and error, and we have 10 specific kids that are doing this 3D club that are really paving the way for the rest of our students in our school. These are very creative kids, kids that know how to work individually but collaboratively. They're kids that we know are going to be able to handle the failure of trying to design something on a website and then print it out and it doesn't quite look like it should. So these are some leaders that we have here at Camden. The goal is that student at Camden K through 5.
You don't have to be by that. You don't have to even be in the presence of that 3D printer to use it, all right, to make your designs. That's all on programs online. And so we want that to be available to every student. K-5 can make their designs at home, with each other on weekends, nights, whatever, and a lot of programs we're looking at, we're making collaborative so multiple kids can be looking at the same project. And then they bring in their thumb drive or email it in, and we start the printout in the morning. By the time they leave school, there's their design. And they may find that it has a lot of flaws, or they may find that they finally perfected something they've been working on for months. So we're really excited about our 3D printing club. One person I talked to when we were doing all this research, I had one person laugh at me. One person laugh at me and say, what are you going to do, make Christmas ornaments with elementary kids? And that's kind of been our motivation. No, we're not making Christmas ornaments with our 3D printer. Our kids are going to try to solve real-world problems, whether it's something, a need they have at their house, in their community, or a global need. What's interesting is there wasn't a single one of our 10 students we talked last week that talked about, I can't wait to make a car. You know, they already have started to think about things that they can do to make their community better by being able to design something that no one ever has thought of before. So here's three of our 10 leaders that are going to pave the way for the rest of our students here.
Let's ask them, Mr. Martin, have you all, you're in the very beginning stages of this club. Any ideas about what you might like to do with this equipment?
Jesse, why don't you describe your weekend with my egg?
Well, I was thinking about the egg that they made, and I thought, well, I could make the feet and the part that was in the egg whole, and then make the feet separate, so that I could set the egg on the feet, and then an egg with the feet.
Gotcha. So, other ideas? Or it's too soon to ask. We'll have to talk to you same time next year, okay? Be here. It's amazing to me how far we've come with 3D printer technology. Also, because we were at a school board meeting not long ago at Oldham County Middle School, where they too are using a 3D printer. And they shared with us some of the things that they had made. So I'm looking at some future engineers, I think, Mr. Martin.
Yes, you are.
So keep up the good work, you guys. Thank you.
The last thing we have is our Lego robotics. We're in our third year of Lego robotics. This will be our first year of competition, though. So we have three robots. We've had those all 3 years. And Ms. Shop and Ms. Murphy are our sponsors for that working. And we have 6 kids here tonight. But I'm going to hand the microphone to them in a second. We have a quick video for you, and then I'm going to turn it over to Lego Robotics. They are going to perform a couple of their activities that they're doing in the competition next week.
Students to think creatively in order to solve real-world engineering problems. Members are doing it completely. complete missions based on current events using their own imaginations and curiosity. With teamwork, students design, build, and test robots using special LEGO Mindstorms technology. Not only are students given missions to complete using the robot, they are also asked to complete research regarding the challenges facing today's scientists. How does the brain work? How can we best teach others how to complete a new and novel task? These are only some of the questions our young minds are answering as we prepare for our robotic competition on December 6th.
And while many of our days are tough and wrought with frustration over failing program or a difficult mechanical attachment, we still manage to find joy and fulfillment for each practice. We are truly building skills that will help us as we join the world members within the next decade.
We currently have three one-on-one iPad labs here at Camden. They are in kindergarten, third grade, and fifth grade. Students at each grade level use their devices for a variety of many different purposes. At the kindergarten level, the teacher intentionally limits the amount of screen time based on research and strikes a balance between traditional tools such as writer's notebooks and picture books and iPads. In third and fifth grade lab sites, teachers use their student iPads as tools for learning that will prepare students for the 21st century. Currently, students use the devices to demonstrate learning, communicate with peers through blogging, acquire new learning through ebooks, digital articles and videos, and practice and apply learned skills through math and literacy apps in varying degrees of difficulty. The uses of one-on-one iPad live sites in conjunction with best practice instruction provides a meaningful learning environment for our 21st century learners. 3D Printing Club. This year, we launched the 3D Printing Club here at Camden Station as a new after-school activity. After 2 years of research, specifically on creative and innovative uses for 3D printing and how 3D printing can be used effectively at the elementary level, our club has begun. Some of the goals of the club are introducing students to the design process by starting with a simple problem that affects our immediate lives or impacts our school experience. We will be involved in the identification of a problem as this is part of the design process. Once solutions and prototypes have been created, tested, and improved to a specific real-life problem for students, we will look for opportunities to think bigger than just our school. Our goal is to tackle community, environmental, and global needs. Students will use their creativity, innovation, critical thinking, and problem-solving skills to design and develop useful items. Students will also research different designs on the internet with the goal of sparking new ideas and or improving upon already established designs. Our ultimate goal, a few years down the road, is that every student at Camden has access to a 3D printer. We are laying the groundwork for creativity and innovation in this area and know that a future Camden students will take it to the next level.
All right, Ethan Jasinski here is going to take the microphone and they're going to run through. We're hoping the battery may have gone down because they've been practicing so much, but we're hoping that it stays up here so it can get through one of these tasks.
Well, I'm Ethan Jasinski, Mr. Davis, Ben Baker, Cameron Soldo, Virginia Golan, Brandon Park, and we're 6 Wonders of LEGO Robotics. If you're wondering about our t-shirts, we designed them ourselves, and we're just going to show you some things we're going to do.
In the 2014 FLL World Class Challenge, over 265,000 children from 80 countries will redesign how we gather knowledge and skills in the 21st century. Our research question was, how can we improve the way someone learns place value? We studied how the brain learns, especially through music. We feel like place value is a very boring concept for some people, and if you're bored, it's very hard to stay focused. When you listen to an educational song, you are exercising both sides of your brain because your left brain is learning the concept of the song and the right brain is focused on the music and the sound. Since your right brain remembers the music, your left brain automatically remembers the words and the math concept. We interviewed teachers at Camden and found that many of them use our music in catchy tunes to help their students learn. We wrote a song about place value. The song is to a catchy tune that most people know nowadays, Shake It Off by Taylor Swift. Our song is called Place It Up. We also created a music video to share with teachers at Camden who teach place value and with the world on YouTube. Teachers can show this video to their students to teach, reteach, or review place value. We have a QR code to take you to our YouTube video. We are trying to get as many likes as possible, so we would appreciate it if you would go online and like our video. We are trying to get students from across the world to enjoy learning about place value. Now Ben's going to tell you about our robot.
Now that Jaden has told you about our competition, I will tell you a little bit about our robot while Andrew runs our missions on the board. Our robot has one sensor, the driver sensor. The drivetrain features include features the increase power, decrease power, move at angles, and moves arms and levers. We estimate that our robot uses 581 pieces. For this competition, we will be using three attachments, an arm, a sensor holder, and a basket. The basket attaches to the arm. We programmed our robot using the English language feature. We're using two programs, Program 1 and Program 3. Program 1 is designed to complete the opening doors challenge. Program 3 is designed to complete the adapting to changing conditions and the sports challenge. We have a 90% success rate with opening doors challenge and have a 75% success rate with Program 3, adapting to changing conditions and the sports challenge.
So now that you know about Lego robotics, how will you change the world?